This sensor works with both plastic and glass fibers. Keep in mind that the color and reflectivity of the object determines the detection range capability of the sensor when used in reflex mode. The brighter the object reflecting the light, the easier it'll be to detect. For example, this white object is easily detected, but this darker object at the same distance isn't detected because it doesn't reflect as much light. There's four connections via this M8 connector: supply, signal out, and contamination out. And AutomationDirect does have cables that work with this M8 connector. You can mount it via 35mm DIN rail or side mount via these screw holes. Beware, there is a max ambient light spec. Bright sunlight can be greater than the 10,000 lumen max spec, so you'll want to avoid using these in direct sunlight. And my favorite, this sensor has a high contrast organic LED display that eliminates all the button press guesswork of the other sensors with easy to understand menus. And this bar graph of the signal strength is awesome when trying to set up the sensor or debug why it isn't working, because you can see at a glance how much light the object is returning to the sensor. This line on the bar graph is the detection threshold. Objects reflecting more light than that will be detected. And the width of that line is the width of the hysteresis. You can also see a numeric version of the signal strength and the output status. If this output status is blinking, that's an indication that the signal is weak and the sensor optics might be dirty or fouled and need to be cleaned. And the best part of all this is you can customize the display to show only the items you want to see. We'll see how to do that in a couple minutes, so let's take a quick walk through the sensor's menu structure, do some quick examples of most of these features, and point out some things you need to know along with some other helpful hints. Here we go. This sensor has 6 teach modes to automatically set the correct sensing distance and a manual way to set the detection distance. There's a real good explanation of what all these teach modes are in the family overview video, so we won't go into that here. We'll just walk through how to set each one up on the sensor. For normal teach, press the enter button and down arrow to bring up the teach menu, and press enter to drop down into the teach submenu. Normal teach is the first one, so hit enter. Place the object in front of the sensor. Notice that we are at a signal strength of around 600, and hit the T button. The display tells you the teach was successful. This vertical line here on the signal strength bar tells you where the cutoff is. We taught the sensor here at around 600, but any object that crosses in front of the sensor as low as around 300 will be detected. That's important to understand. Teach automatically adds in a buffer, so you don't need to worry about that. Hit the enter button to exit, up arrow, and hit enter to go back to run. And sure enough, the sensor detects any object down to about the mid-300s. Notice that the vertical bar has some width to it. That's the hysteresis region. The signal has to fall below that region before the sensor status will indicate a loss of detection. Minimal teach is the exact same thing. But let's do it anyway so we can see if we get a different result. Enter into the menu, down to teach, enter into the teach submenu. Down arrow to minimal and hit enter. Let's do the exact same thing. Set the object near 600 and hit T for teach, and it was successful. Well, you can see on the bar graph that the buffer is a lot smaller with minimal teach, isn't it? Looks like it's around the mid to upper 400s. Remember, minimal teach has a minimal buffer. Hit the enter button to exit, arrow up and hit enter to go back to run, and sure enough, the sensor detects objects down to the upper 400s, exactly what we expect. To set up dynamic teach, we drop down into that mode, but this time don't have any objects in front of the sensor. Here I have the sensor looking down on my pretend conveyor belt. We start dynamic teach by pressing T1. It says it's recording. Then start the conveyor, have objects pass by, and press T2 when you're done. The sensor automatically places the cutoff where it thinks the optimal place is between the two objects. Looks like this one's about 540. So if we go back to run, sure enough we see that the large object is detected, but the smaller one isn't. Perfect. Two-point teach is the same as dynamic teach, except you manually choose the points. Put the first object under the sensor and press T1. Put the second object under the sensor and press T2. And since we use the same objects, guess what? We get the same answer. And sure enough, in run mode, the sensor only detects the larger object. In window teach, you put the object in front of the sensor and hit T1. And if I move the object out of the way, you see two lines. Any object that passes between those two levels or within that window of values will be detected. Let's go back to run, and if an object's too far away, it won't be detected, and if it's too close, it won't be detected. Only objects within the window will be detected. You can adjust the size of that window in the window size menu. The window width is currently set to these two values. Just use the plus and minus keys to make it bigger or smaller. You can also move the center of the window or any teach threshold with the potentiometer menu. This number tells you where the current object is. This number is the threshold. Use the plus and minus keys to move that threshold around. The final teach mode is background. Just point the sensor at the background and hit the T key. The sensor automatically sets the threshold just above the background. There's also a hysteresis setting that you can adjust just like all the others. The only catch is the amount of hysteresis you can use depends on the sensitivity setting you set for the sensor. This sensor is on high sensitivity, so I can only select a hysteresis of 45 to 200. On normal sensitivity, you can change the hysteresis from 20 to 200. External teach does the same thing as we just did, but instead of pressing buttons to select the thresholds, you apply 10 to 30 volts to pin 2. Now, external teach isn't a menu item. When that voltage is applied to the sensor, it will reteach a detection threshold as if the sensor was in whatever mode you last taught. So you have to teach a mode via button presses first, and then you'll be able to use external teach. Also, you can't do two-point teach via external teach, and dynamic teach teaches as long as the voltage is applied. You can select the output type to be PNP or push and pull. Now, the title of the submenu is PNP-MPN, and there is a menu selection for MPN, but you can't actually select it on this sensor because the extra pin you would need to add the MPN output is used for a teach input. This is just a generic menu that's used on multiple sensors, so instead of changing the menu structure, they just disabled the MPN option on this sensor. You can select normally open or normally closed. Some folks call that light on or dark on. For on delay, you can change the value from 0 to 10,000 milliseconds, and off delay is the same. You can specify an impulse output instead of a discrete high or low, and specify the width of that impulse. Notice that every time the digit cycles, it starts incrementing the next digit, so getting to large numbers is pretty quick. Let's set it to 1 second and exit back out to run mode. If we put an object in front of the sensor head, we see the output only lasts for 1 second, exactly what we expect. Operating mode is where we set the sensor sensitivity that we mentioned earlier. The high sensitivity setting is for extending the detection range so you can detect objects a little further away. You can filter the signal to reduce false alarms. There are 8 filter settings, but beware, each one reduces the switching frequency of the sensor. The sensor's switching frequency is how fast it can make a decision. You can rotate the display, which is handy if you have to mount the sensor upside down. You can adjust the display brightness, you can zoom the bar graph, you can even specify which display elements you want to see on the display. You can choose the language of the display, and you can see the firmware version of the sensor. And finally, you can do a factory reset, and you can set a password which will prevent others from changing your settings. Well, that ought to be enough to get you going. If you have any questions, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help. And don't forget the forums. There are lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any questions for Automation Direct's support team there. They don't monitor the forums on a regular basis.